Jordan Terrell Carter was born on September 13th, 1996, which also happens to be the same day our Lord and rap savior Tupac died. Now, I'm not saying Carti is the reincarnation of Tupac, but... He was born in Riverdale, Georgia. No, not that Riverdale. Carti was always a rebel, even from the beginning. In a 2016 interview with Complex, he said, "My ma couldn't tell me shit. Nobody could tell me shit." This attitude led him to spending his youth very troubled. In high school, Carti wanted to become an NBA star to make something of himself. But because he was ducking school so much, he would skip practice too. But when he did go to practice, he was usually stoned. This eventually led to a disagreement with his coach, so then he went on to quit and focus on music instead. Off topic, but there's definitely an alternate reality where Carti's an NBA star, and that just cracks me up. Carti was constantly skipping school to work on music or go to his job at H&M. He was actually so close to not graduating that nobody even showed up to his graduation because no one thought he was actually going to graduate. So now that we got the supervillain origin story out the way, let's get right into the beginning years of his musical career. I started out bad-handling and peppin' out some bitches. I'm a fat cat, so my bitches with the digits. I count my finger and not the fidgets. Let's count, I need to come back. Figures to figure out what I'm at now. It all started in 2011 when he started rapping under the moniker Sir Cartier and dropped his first mixtape, Young Misfit, in 2012. He was also in a rap group called TFZ with lifelong friend Uno the Activist, who were long believed to be cousins until Uno finally cleared it up. 2014 is when things really started to change for Carti. He dropped the Sir Cartier name and finally started rapping as Playboi Carti. Around this time is when Carti signed to Awful Records. Awful Records is the label that the rapper Father started in 2014. One of the first songs he dropped under the label was Young Zan Ho. I'm sad as fuck. Zan. 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 Gotta put some swag Zan. On it, right? An atmospheric trap banger that sampled the PS2 startup sound. Carti continued to work with more Atlanta underground rappers such as Uno the Activist, Thousand Banfani, Young Bands, and producers such as Mexico Drill and Icy Twat. Carti cites Father, Key, and most importantly, Ethereal as his early mentors. Carti credits Ethereal to helping him find his sound and style during the early stages of his career. In a 2018 interview with Dazed, Carti said, "When I met Ethereal, I was looking for the shit that he was already doing. I was like, wow, this is the guy. Ethereal is a legend. Without him, I don't know where the fuck I'd be. He's a good dude, so talented. He's another GOAT. I'm not even talking about his music right now. As a human, that man is a really good dude." Ethereal produced many of Carti's early tracks, and he's often accredited as an early pioneer of the psychedelic trap wave that we hear today. They dropped many classic tracks together like For the People, I Know You Know, and Beef. In a Hellcat, yeah, burning up, let the window down, yeah, lay it out, what, laying niggas down, lay them down, what, I'ma hit that bitch with 100 rounds. Things really started to change for Carti in 2015 when he relocated from Atlanta to the Bronx. He started picking up traction after dropping songs like Broke Boy and Fetty, featuring Dash and Maxo Cream. While in New York City, Carti was staying at his drug dealer's house, which also happened to be a house ASAP Mob members would frequently visit. This led to him crossing paths with ASAP Bari, which led to Carti going to a house party and meeting ASAP Rocky. Rocky said he fucked Carti.
Hold up.
Fucking start sucking off ASAP Rocky. Fucking Ferg walks up. I unzip his pants. I'm jerking him off, sucking off ASAP Rocky. What was the question?
Hold up.
Rocky said he fucked with Carti and decided to take him under his wings, which was probably the most instrumental thing to Playboi Carti's career. He began touring alongside ASAP Ferg and Lil Uzi Vert, and eventually signed with Interscope Records under ASAP Mob's OG imprint. In 2016, he had his first major feature on the ASAP Mob song, Telephone Calls, alongside Rocky, Tyler the Creator, and Young Gleesh. He was also on the song London Town on Cozy Tape Volume 1, which is also a banger. Check it out. At this point, Carti was on top of the world and had nowhere to go but up. On March 17, 2017, Carti dropped the first single off his upcoming mixtape, Lookin', featuring Lil Uzi Vert. Then on April 7th, he dropped Woke Up Like This, which also featured Lil Uzi. A week later, he finally dropped his long-awaited mixtape, Playboi Carti. The mixtape brought production from Harry Fraud, Southside, Mexico Jero, Pierre Bourne, and many more. The critical reception was fairly positive, with many praising how Carti just rides the instrumentals and is a part of the beat. But that's also why many didn't like it. The mixtape brought us bangers like the previously mentioned Lookin' and Woke Up Like This, but it also gave us Location, New Choppa, Other Shit, and most importantly, Magnolia.
Run that shit back, yo, man.
Magnolia was a song that really put Carti on the map. If you were into hip hop at the time and still didn't know who Carti was, now you do. That song was everywhere. It also helped that the music video was fantastic, being directed by Higgy Films. The video brought us trippy visuals and gave us many cameos from people popping off at the hip hop scene around the time. The success of Self-Titled gave Carti way more attention, which led to him being picked for XXL's 2017 freshman list, alongside other artists such as Made in Tokyo, Aminé, Ugly God, and XXXTentacion. Later in 2017, Carti also had a few appearances on ASAP Mob's Cozy Tapes Volume 2, which is personally one of my favorite summer albums of all time. Everyone needs to check that album out. Fire. After that, Carti decided to lay low, plot, and see what his next moves were. In December 2017, we started getting our first teases of Die Lit with a video of Carti working as that album mode, which started to get fans hyped for what's next. In March 2018, Pierre Bourne announced he was working on the album and that it was almost finished. Then on May 10, 2018, Carti tweeted that the album would be out the next day, with ASAP Rocky posting the album artwork on his Instagram. The surprise announcement had fans everywhere hyped for what they were about to hear. Die Lit came out on May 11th, 2018, and was executively produced by Pierre Bourne, who did most of the production alongside Don Cannon, Indigo Child Rick, and Molly Raw. It gave us features from Skepta, Travis Scott, Lil Uzi Vert, Pierre Bourne, Nicki Minaj, Bryson Tiller, Chief Keef, Gunna, Red Cole Hearted, Young Thug, and Young Nudie. I would say most of the guests killed it, except maybe for the best feature out the Big Apple since FaceTime. Die Lit brought a lot of bubbly, atmospheric sounds that was a signature for Pierre. It also gave birth to that of baby voice Carti, something that is very divisive amongst listeners. Some loved the new approach and loved how new and fresh it was, while others couldn't stand the new approach he tried to take. Critics took pretty kindly to this new approach, which led to a whole new wave of Carti fans.
Shawty just pulled up just to get fucked.
yeah, for sure.
After Die Lit, Carti became mainstream and immediately started hyping up his sophomore album, Whole Lotta Red. And many people were excited for what was coming, especially from the way he was sounding on the leaks. These leaks would get posted on streaming services and accumulate millions of streams. Songs like Goku, Molly, and Cancun all became favorites amongst the community, even though they didn't have an official release. And then of course, there's Pissy Pamper. Pissy Pamper was originally a Young Nudie song that was supposed to appear on his joint album with Pierre Bourne, Slimier. The song never showed up on that album because Pierre couldn't get the sample cleared, but that didn't stop it from seeing the light of day. Originally called Kid Cudi amongst the fanbase, this song took over the world by storm. A re-upload of the track appeared on Spotify and reached number one on Spotify's US Viral 50 chart. The song also became popular because all of the memes they spawned. Pissy Pamper was so catchy and addictive and somehow made Carti even more popular, which is crazy because the song never even had an official release. And during all of this, Carti was still gaining more prominence for his baby voice with features on Tyler, the Creator's Earthquake and, I'm gonna pronounce this wrong, Solange's Almeida. I like that song though. And while all of this was going on, Carti was still teasing his upcoming album, Whole Lotta Red. He kept giving us vague release dates and teases that led to nothing until April 16th, 2020, when he finally released the single, At Me. This song divided the fanbase, though, and failed to fully please them. Many found his use of the baby voice too annoying and couldn't handle it on the song. His feature on Drake's Pain 1993 also made people wary of what to come. This made fans fearful of Whole Lotta Red, thinking the whole album would sound like trash. But they were very, very wrong, because fans didn't even get to hear what it sounded like. Nothing came from that, and it only managed to make fans more impatient. So impatient, in fact, that it spawned a fan to make his own Whole Lotta Red. This fan was Mario Judah. And I don't want to get too into Mario Judah, because that's a video in and of itself. Mario brought a whole lot of attention to a whole lot of red, basically forcing Carti to drop it before he did it for him. Carti kept posting new snippets. That were sounding interesting, and even posted a video of him and Kid Cudi in the studio playing a new Cudi verse on Pissy Pamper. This all just built up to immeasurable hype that Carti could never realistically meet for every fan. But alas, the album still had to come out, and on December 21st, it was made official. Carti announced the album was coming out Christmas Day, along with showing the cover and stating the album was going to be executively produced by Kanye West. Finally, the wait was over. But was it worth it? Whole Lotta Red dropped on December 25th, 2020, with production from Filthy, Molly Raw, Pierre Bourne, and many more. It also gave us features from Kanye West, Kid Cudi, and Future. The album was polarizing at release, but that was to be expected from the way it sounded. And the way it sounded was unlike anything Carti had made before. Songs like Rockstar Made, Stop Breathing, and Jump Out the House brought energy unmatched to any of his previous work. Carti took a more raw and angry approach to this album, preferring to screech more than talking like a baby. He also had more classic Dilett-esque songs on the album, like Place, New Neon, and I Love You, I Hate You. Many people said Carti fell off, that this album was a whole lot of ass, but just as many people were praising how bold and unique the direction he took was. And over time, the album became more well-regarded and basically formed the way for a lot of newer hip-hop acts to expand on this sound. Artists like Ken Carson, Yeat, and Casey started blowing up after this album, and also producer Filthy, who's been killing it and still killing it, making a collab album with Lucky and working with artists like Aminé and Lil Yachty. Not too long after Whole Lotta Red, Carti appeared on Trippy Red's Miss the Rage, which was a huge hit for both of them and really propelled that rage sound to the mainstream. He also showed up on Lil 1 DTE's song Homicide, and it had multiple features on Kanye West's Donda and on Abra's Unlock It. And since then, Carti has stayed pretty low-key besides teasing Narcissus, which amounted to nothing but a tour rename. But whatever Carti has planned next is sure to be something brand new and fresh and unlike any of his previous projects if he continues to push his sound.
I'm on the top of the Bentley. 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 I'm on the top of the Bentley.
Playboi Carti is an artist I have a lot of love for, but it wasn't always that way for me. I wasn't on the hype train until Dilett dropped. I didn't understand Carti at first. His flow and cadence just didn't appeal to me. And then there was his XXL freestyle, which didn't help at all.
Yeah, hide it in my sock, hide it in my sock, ooh, serving every rock. First I park my car, then I pull the walk. I'm a walk star, I'm a pop star, ay, pop a lot of beef, ay. She just on the team, ay. She just want a fiend, she just want a dream, ay. I just got a new hoe, that's my favorite bitch, ay. I just got a new watch, diamonds on my wrist, ay. Yeah, ay, nigga watch this, ay. LV's up, Kim Jones in my line, had to plug up, ay. All these hoes want to fuck cause I'm money up, ay. Counting all this cash, got a nigga money tied, ay. Nigga ain't right, then the nigga getting fired. I don't really fight, nigga, hit him where he lying, ay. Stop the cap and stop the line.
Carti finally clicked when I had my first blunt and heard Flatbed Freestyle. That day, everything changed. I realized Carti was just doing whatever he wanted and that he didn't care what others thought. He was gonna do his own thing. And after researching for this video, that's really what he's been doing his whole life. He never wanted to be told what to do. Whether it was his mom, basketball coach, or even his own fans that wanted him to stagnate in the same sound. Carti's always pushed boundaries, and he'll always continue to do that. Unless he doesn't, then I'll eat my weights. So that's all for this video. I didn't feel like focusing on his love life with Iggy or any other drama. I wanted to focus on the music, how his sound has evolved over the years. Which is crazy how you listen to his first song, you listen to something like Stop Breathing. It's a huge difference. Like, well, I'll put something up right now. I'll hear it. You can hear it back. Like that, yeah, that's crazy, isn't it? It doesn't even sound like that anymore. Well, remember, like and subscribe. If you enjoyed the video, like and subscribe. And I'll see you next time, man. Stay smooth.
Bye, have a beautiful time.